G'day everyone. My name is David. I'm an engineer from the University of New South Wales here in Sydney. And today I want to talk to you about building a community of learners. But it's not just about education. Take that awesome video we just saw. It's incredible what we can do with AI and technology today, how we can infuse it into completely different industries. So at UNSW, we have over 65,000 students. Our engineering faculty has 17,000 students now, making us the biggest engineering faculty in Australia. But we're also big on an international scale. Just our engineering faculty alone is bigger than Stanford University. I'm now teaching up to 1,000 students. In fact, this semester alone, I've got two classes of 500. And those are my actual students there. When you look at it, it's a sample space where you have someone from every walk of life, every accessibility requirement, every socioeconomic restriction, people who are working part-time, have caring duties, maybe they're young mums. There's every possible walk of life, and we need to open education up to everybody. So if you look at digital education today, it's so much about consumption. Download this PDF, watch this video, read this, consume, consume. It's student versus the website. And my project is, can we turn things backwards? Can we turn education into a creative, collaborative experience? Treat education like a blank book with a table of contents where we write it together. So a few years ago in 2017, I started by doing something very simple. I worked with my IT team and we created a PowerShell script to sync all of our students into an Office 365 group, opening up the power of an enterprise class platform. I started using Teams to replace my online student forums. Now we were able to communicate with diagrams, hand-drawn mathematics, pictures, and code snippets. And all of that lecture material was just going straight into the channels in Teams, pinned, everything aggregated together in one place and stored on SharePoint. OneNote Class Notebook, a tool on OneNote where Teams, every channel creates automatically a section, and all of that digital ink, all of those calculations that I do are shared between me and my students in real time. I use Teams live events to live produce and live broadcast my lectures. My students are able to write comments in the chat if they're not in the lecture theater and I can answer them live. And look here, I'm giving a lecture about axial testing. This is something where we do calculations and we compare it with the lab results. When those lectures are done, Power Automate automatically takes that file and writes it to a stream gallery pinned right there as a tab in Teams. And it's amazing what Stream can do. It's automatically creating closed captions with highly technical language. All of that information is there, including analytics and the ability to have interactive modules built in. Simple things like assignments. Now, I can give them Word documents, but they're hosted in real time, live on SharePoint. I have all of the metadata, version history, and this improves the integrity of my assessment. And line of business apps, like our Moodle system, is now integrated as an app natively within Teams. Forms allows me to make quizzes in a few minutes for my students. And my favorite software, like MATLAB Online, for example, I can pin it as a tab right there in Teams, anywhere, anytime, any device. And now I can build beautiful SharePoint pages, integrate them within Teams. And it's not just about iframing or links or pointing it to different places. The resources are actually there natively on SharePoint. And when my students go to the tutorial, my teaching assistants put their grades straight into Power Apps that we've built. Using Power Platform, it writes it straight to the system SQL. And you know, this isn't just one way. This platform is also able to pull the data for those students and put it right there in front of the TA. This is very empathetic. This has given my teaching assistants the data right that moment when they're sitting down with the students, when they might need to reach out and offer extra help. And when they're done, the data flows back into SharePoint and it checks off for the student. In fact, with this platform, I now have 10 times the engagement that I used to have. And when I say that, I mean it. I've got now insights within Teams giving me the data. 200 posts in a semester is now 2,000 posts in a semester. But you know, what do you do when you have thousands of posts? How do you make sure you never miss a question? Well, I built a bot on bot framework. It's called Question. Question treats every student's question like a service ticket. It connects with the right people. When the TAs come in and answer those questions, it's logged off and it's read as a question and answer pair automatically. It works fantastically on mobile, of course, and it creates a study material Q&A within the team channel. In fact, over the course of the semester, my bot automatically logged 1,000 Q&A pairs topic categorized. And so what do you do with all that? Well, we automatically write it to an Azure Cognitive Service Q&A maker, and the bot is able to train its own AI. And it doesn't try to answer questions on its own, it tries to redirect the students back to the conversation, reconnecting them with their peers. But sometimes students post photos, and how do we get context out of a photograph? Well, I started putting QR codes on all the learning material, and we use vision APIs. The bot is able to read it and say, hey, I see you're working on question 4.1. Then it can pull in relevant information from Azure Blob Storage and redirect the students to more valuable learning resources. The bot can also search those stream transcripts and drop deep linked lecture links on stream right to the exact second. This was built by local developers and Antares here in Sydney in collaboration with UNSW. The fire hose of conversation turned from a problem into a digital asset, something that I can now leverage to make a better educational experience. So remember that axial testing lecture I showed you? Well, you know what? We have that actual machine in our laboratory. We've got tens of millions of dollars of machinery, but we can't get the students in there because of safety, inductions. You're only allowed 12 people in that room. It just doesn't scale. Imagine if we could just digitize that in real time using augmented reality. Well, I did a project with UNSW's immersive technologies team. We can also digitize in real time the lecture theater. And we can put the experiment in the lecture
theater.
Okay, so
we've done our calculation here for the test specimen, and we're getting a total deflection of about 4.2 millimeters. So let's just jump over to the lab. We've got the same test specimen in here running, and let's see when it breaks.
So now I can bring the laboratory into the lecture theater. Now this technology is helping me to scale what used to be an unscalable experience. Everything we now do is live, creative, and collaborative. No more consumption. And all of that data, all of that information for the students, I use Power Platform and bring it live into a Power BI dashboard. This allows the students, just with one click in a tab in Teams, to contextualize their learning to see where they're at. And of course, it reflows on mobile. All of this data is stored. We've got structured data, we've got unstructured data. What do we do with that? Well, I took 2017 data and I used an Azure machine learning model to train all of it against individual performance in individual exam questions. And I applied this model to my next class, and I was able to predict the performance of every student in every question 2 weeks before the exam. And now, with the resource of categorized, topic-filtered resources, I have a .NET algorithm that automatically generates 500 personalized study packs for every single student. Uploaded to SharePoint with individual access rights, pinned one click in Teams, a personal optimized study resource for every one of my students. So now comes the final exams. How can we automate low-value tasks, like marking blank papers or ticking something that's 100%? How can we get back more time to give students value, feedback, something that matters to their learning experience? Well, I actually end up with 24,000 pages of hand-drawn engineering calculations and diagrams over the course of a semester. I built a system to scan all of it with my team to digitize everything and turn it into an online assignment. And using Azure Machine Learning, I can train an ML model against the marking rubric to identify key components of diagrammatic solutions. And now, with an Azure app that's pinned right there in a private channel on Teams, 3 seconds later, an Azure Machine Learning can identify all of the key points of hand-drawn engineering diagrams. Let's have a look here at an incorrect answer. Have a look at the feedback. X and Y axis is missing. No reaction forces at A. Missing reaction forces at B. This is wild. I can use Graph API and Teams assignments and write all of this data and pre-fill it within the Teams assignments app. Now when we're marking, we already have AI suggestions in there. We can either click through and confirm or filter out things like a blank page. A human never even has to see that. We can now spend more time doing the things that matter, like giving feedback to a student that had an attempt but got it wrong, and we can tell them why. This gives us more time to do the things that matter. So what happens next? Well, we've got all of this information within a course, but you know, the course has got assessments that are mapped to learning outcomes, and we can log all of that in Dynamics and pull it into a system. We've got all of the marks that are coming out of Office, and we've got all of those Azure apps, as well as an Azure Data Factory that can connect to our line of business systems like PeopleSoft. We can calculate a kind of educational graph, a map that charts student curriculum through to all of their various skills that they're developing throughout the course of a program. And now, for the first time ever, I can show you a project that I've been collaborating with Microsoft Education on. It's called Project Lagro. And this brings in the entire LinkedIn graph, the whole data system, with the Microsoft graph, and it combines it with our own educational data in order to map student skills against careers and professional development. This is an app within Teams. The students can connect to it, add their LinkedIn or create a new LinkedIn, start their professional development, their professional journey from first year of their degree. They can explore skills, and they can connect with alumni and jobs within their own university network. And this system is using Azure Cognitive Services to automatically create a map of that student's skills by using all of the different resources they have. They can explore skills that they have and skills that they need based on that LinkedIn graph. And this is able to surface not only our own tools, our own electives that that student can do, but free online tools and tools that we subscribe to as an institution, like various training courses within LinkedIn Learning. So I want to give you an example here. We've searched artificial intelligence. Now, I'm an engineer by training, but I find myself a couple of decades after graduation working more in AI. And so I have all of these resources at hand myself because I'm a lifelong learner and I want to teach my students the habit of lifelong learning too. This is a huge potential system. We're now turning education into a constant progress towards skills development throughout a whole career. So, can we create a community of learners? Can technology enhance our ability to do that? And can we instill a habit of lifelong learning? Well, I've asked my students, for example, are you satisfied with this course? 4 years ago, this was around 74%. I'm now at over 99% satisfaction, teaching more students than ever. AI is allowing me to reach out to people in need, to classify and create tailored experiences for every student. I asked my students, do you feel part of a learning community? And 100% of them said yes. When I look at that room now, I see the greatest asset of all, the people. Every student has got 599 other students to connect with, 599 other brilliant minds to collaborate with and to create with, to learn from together as a single team. And it's incredible, you know, because this thing, artificial intelligence, that we think of as being inhuman, is allowing us to do something very, very humanistic, to reach out to people in need, to create personalized experiences. So today I want to tell you something exciting. Everything that I am building on the free Office for Education platform, I'm open sourcing as well, and it's going to be available in GitHub starting with QuestionBot this December. Thank you very much for listening.